The most anticipated new feature in Excel for 2019 is here, XLOOKUP. I'll show you why. If you've used VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, or a combination of index and match, get ready to replace those all with XLOOKUP. For example, let's take a look at XLOOKUP with this value in this list. Now notice I'm not selecting the entire range of data anymore. I'm just picking the array that I'm looking at the data up. And we want to return the value from this March column. So instead of specifying how many columns over, I'm actually highlighting the columns. And that's all you have to do for the XLOOKUP function to find Sally on this row and return the March value of 22,454. Now, one of the nice features of XLOOKUP is it defaults to an exact match. So if you come back here, the next parameter is exact match, but you can also specify exact or the next smaller item, exact or the next larger item, or do a wildcard character match like the index match function. So let's take a look at the horizontal search like HLOOKUP. Let's do an XLOOKUP of March. This time we're going to pick this row of data and we want it to return the row for Sally. And you can see that it also returned the 22,454 because it found March and went down to the row for Sally. Now one of the other parameters for XLOOKUP, let's say we're looking up 46% in this list and we want to return the January data. Notice it doesn't find 46 in the list, so it returns an NA. But let's put in there the exact match or next smaller item. And 45 is the next lower item, and it returns 22,793 from the January column. Let's do the same thing, but this time we're going to pick the exact match or next larger item. And the next larger is 50. So it returns this value. Another great feature of XLOOKUP, let's say we're looking up Sally in this list, but instead of returning just the March column, let's do the entire range. See what it did? It returned the values for the entire range that I selected for just Sally, 22,793 through 26,992. Now let's do a wildcard search. But this time we're going to put in there J question mark in this list. And we're going to return the March column again. This time we're going to pick a wildcard character match. This is going to look for J with two letters following it and return the 31097, which is Jim for March. I can do the same thing with an asterisk. And it finds the first J with anything following it. Now another cool feature is the next parameter, which allows you to search first to last by default, but you can search last to first. So let's find anything that starts with a J starting from the bottom of the list backwards. And notice it returned 31,298, which is this value here, because that's the last one in the list starting with a J. You can even combine XLOOKUP functions to be even more powerful. So let's do an XLOOKUP of Sally in this list, and we'll return the data for March. And we have our 22,454, which is this value right here. But this time, let's take this second array and replace it with another XLOOKUP function. And we're going to look up this value in this set of data, and we're going to return the entire array of data in parentheses. And you can see that it returned 22,454, which is the intersection of Sally and March. So now if I change these values to February, it returns 28,391, which is the intersection of Sally and February. Change this to John. And you return 17,232. And that's the power of the XLOOKUP function. You should receive this in the winter 2019 release of any Excel updates. and you should be able to use this to replace VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, and index match combinations for this point forward. Enjoy. Hey, if you want to see more videos like this one, please subscribe. And if you've enjoyed this video, be sure to click the thumbs up and leave a comment. I really do appreciate your support.